Hello, my name is Mike, and I want to show you how to redirect your users based on conditional dropdown fields. About 2 years ago, we made a conditional dropdown tutorial, and since then, we've had quite a few comments asking for us to expand on how to use it. So in this video, I'll do a quick recap of how to create a conditional dropdown, and then show you how to redirect users to whatever page you want based on what they choose. So quickly, I'll show you the form that I made for our products. As I am running a cell phone store, I made a form called Phones with only two fields, Make and Model, and then imported a CSV with each phone I'm selling. Let's take a quick look at the entries so you can see. If you need a refresh on how to do this first step, watch the first video in this series. Now, let's make the user-facing form with conditional dropdown fields. We'll create a new blank form and call it Choose Your Phone. We'll add two lookup fields to this form, because they will be looking up the entries from the form we already made. I'll drag this field up next to the first one. Let's call the first lookup field Make. We'll get options from our Phones form and its Make field. Let's call the second lookup field Model. We'll get options from our Phones form again, and this time its Model field. We'll also want to watch a lookup field. We'll choose our other lookup field to watch. This would say Make if we updated to save our progress. In fact, let's do that since we're pretty much done with this form. We can go back to check and yes, our Model lookup field is filtering by our Make lookup field. Basically, users won't be able to choose the Apple Galaxy flip phone. If they choose Apple as the Make, only Apple phones will be listed under Model. All right, I have a Buy a Phone page already created to host my new form. Let's go to it, and then add a new Formidable Form block where I can choose my new form. Awesome! Now we have a conditional dropdown form on the page we want. But how do we send users where they want to go based on their selections? Let's look at two options. Go back to our form and look at the default confirmation action. In this case, we don't want to show a message. We want to send them to that specific phone's page. You may have noticed when I was selecting my Buy a Phone page that I had another page called the Samsung Galaxy S23 Ultra. I didn't do it for every phone, but I did make this sample phone page so I can show you how it works. Let's choose Show Page Content, and then choose our Galaxy S23 Ultra page. In the conditional logic portion, we want this confirmation action to occur if the Model field is equal to Galaxy S23 Ultra. Now, I believe every time I've done this conditional logic portion in a past tutorial, I've been able to choose an option from a dropdown here. But because this is a lookup field, pulling data from a separate form, I need to type in the value. Then click confirmation at the top or duplicate this form action and add one for every possible outcome. Yeah, it's a little time consuming. Let's hit update to save what we've done and then check it out. I'll go to my page where I put my form and choose the Galaxy S23 Ultra. I'll click submit and there we go, it shows the phone. That is option one, showing page content. Option two is redirect to URL. This one isn't as time consuming if you name your page slugs right. Let's go check out my Galaxy S23 page. I made sure that my page slug exactly matches the entry for the model of the phone. Yes, there are dashes, but my site auto converts any space into a dash, so it is a match. Now let's go back to our confirmation action. I'll get rid of the conditional logic because we don't need it. Using this method, we only need one confirmation action. We'll put in our site's URL, and then we'll choose the model field ID after the final backslash. Now it will redirect people to that phone's page, and I don't need to make a bunch of different confirmation actions. Let's update to save and try it out. And it works. Notice that this option doesn't load page content where the form was. It's a full redirect. And that's how you can create conditional dropdown fields to redirect users in WordPress. Subscribe for more form building and WordPress tips, and I'll see you next time.